Good evening. Tonight, from Detroit, we go after the story of conflict between big business and big labor, a struggle that promises to shape the future of our entire economic system.
In the early days of the 20th century, the automobile industry is the most important industry in the world. The discipline inside plants tended to be vicious.
You did exactly what the boss told you.
This speed up had to stop. The safety of each of us was threatened.
Kind of glorified gold-plated sweatshop.
If they caught you wearing your union button, you were fired and frequently beat up.
Just because they pay a worker, they don't own him.
And machine after machine were shut down.
We're on strike. It's a sit-down.
Everybody locked the gates, welded the gates.
And they shot tear gas into the plant.
There were a lot of thugs to hurt union people then.
A double-barreled shotgun was fired through the front window.
You have to be willing to put your life on the line if you really believe in a cause.
Union gave the workers dignity.
We felt like we were people again.
What the labor movement had done is force employers to pay really good wages.
From life insurance to pensions to medical insurance, Detroit was the richest city in America.
This union has not interpreted its responsibilities narrowly.
They should demand freedom now, here and now.
And then all of a sudden, all of these things began to erupt.
He knew he was dealing with the golden goose.
We would not accede to the unconscionable demands of a powerful union.
It gave Ruther a lot of power.
There are no secrets. I am running away from nothing.
But Walter said, if I raise this question with Lyndon Johnson, I'm out of there.
Walter found himself somewhat isolated.
Father and Walter and Victor were just so convinced of the righteousness.
And I began shouting at the top of my voice.
He challenged them to participate in that union and to make a difference in terms of people's lives.
We have come together to join hands in a common struggle for justice and human dignity. And nothing will stop us.